you want to be part of what we're doing here at WBONTV.com and advertise with us, email us at information@WBONTV.com or send us a message on Facebook or Twitter. Our video stories now have over 1 million organic views and over 1 million people reached organically. Get watched, get noticed, get Richmond's very own, WBONTV.com.
From the studios of WBONTV.com, I'm Marissa Hempel, and this is your Thursday afternoon news brief. Now that there's a little chill in the air, assistance with heating utilities is more crucial now than ever. Kentucky River Foothills Development Council is here to help for those that apply and are eligible for the Energy Assistance Program. WBONTV went down to the offices to talk to those that assist residents in all the Foothills counties on a daily basis with services such as electric, gas, propane, kerosene, even coal and wood. Watch the video to get all the details for the appointment-based program, which will be ending December 14th. Although this is based on funds that are previously allotted, if you're not able to get assistance before the 14th, also described in the video up now on WBONTV.com, the crisis program for those whose energy source has been terminated begins next month. A Richmond man was taken into custody this week on trafficking charges after Richmond police noticed he had a suspended license. 24-year-old Michael Walters told officers that he was not aware his license was not valid when he was pulled over on East Walnut Street. A plastic bag holding suspected marijuana was allegedly in plain view in the vehicle. When the vehicle was subjected to a search, more marijuana and 7.5 grams of suspected heroin was also located, as well as methamphetamine and cash. Walters was arrested and charged with trafficking methamphetamine and of heroin, possession of paraphernalia, and operating on a suspended license. A Lexington man has been indicted following a deadly crash from earlier this year. 33-year-old Dean Lee Carson Jr. had crashed his SUV into a car which was stopped at a red light. Court documents allege that Carson was under the influence at the time and cocaine was allegedly found at the scene. Carson has been indicted for the murder of the driver of the other vehicle, which is John Rusnak. 18 months in prison is what former Woodford County educator Lindsay Banta Jarvis, 28 years old of Lexington, is now looking at. After she pled guilty in September at Woodford Circuit Court, she's also now being charged in Fayette County for offenses involving the same student. She pled guilty to third-degree rape and third-degree sodomy, which brought up another charge of unlawful transaction being dismissed as part of the plea agreement. Jarvis will be getting 84 days of home incarceration, which will be counting towards her 18 months of prison time. She's also to be sentenced Friday in Fayette Circuit Court on another charge of third-degree rape. Jarvis, a former instructional aide for teachers, resigned last year from Fayette County Schools, and before this, she worked in Woodford School District as a social studies teacher. For more stories such as these, be sure to visit Richmond's very own WBONTV.com. I'm Marissa Hempel.